I'm Blake Biondi. I'm committed to the University of Minnesota Duluth. And this is everything college hockey.
Tell us more about your decision to come back for another year of high school instead of going to juniors. And is there anyone that said, hey, Blake, we want you back this year?
No, it was kind of just my decision. I always, growing up with these guys, I just always kind of wanted to come back. I couldn't see myself playing anywhere else. Like, my hometown was one of my best friends. Like, obviously, last year didn't go the way I wanted to either. And
right.
We really wanted to get a better run at it. So, obviously, it wasn't anybody else. It was, I just kind of thought, like, they're giving me everything, so I kind of want to.
Get the last chance to check to that.
Yeah, for sure.
Favorite part of any of us about you?
It's obviously, I think it's probably just putting on the jersey, like playing in Russia and Sweden. Like, it's unbelievable feeling. It's kind of surreal, honestly. Probably the best part, is. First morning to Russia, but that was crazy.
Is it different? Is it harder to adjust to their game since they play a different game?
Yeah. I mean, we obviously had our own strategy in place, and we followed that. But it's a different hockey over there for sure, and it didn't go where we wanted to. But anytime you put on the jersey, it's unbelievable.
Is there any of those kids? I mean, obviously you make a strong bond with those kids that you're suiting up next to. Do you still talk to a lot of those guys?
Yeah. I miss them actually right now. I know a lot of them still, and we're close. I've kind of known them before this too, and then. Good chunk of them, obviously. It creates a great bond, especially when you're in your country together.
So last year, you guys in Hermantown were ranked number one all season, and then you lose to Greenway in the section final. You know, how hard was that loss, and how does that motivate you for the upcoming season?
Yeah, that was one of the toughest things in my life so far. I mean, my hockey career it was awful. You know, when you let the community down like that, it's what it feels like, and it was an awful feeling, and you just never really ever want to feel that again. So. We're doing everything we can to get back to the X, and with my best friends, and I know everyone's on board with that, so really excited to start the season.
Sure. So Blake, what's it like playing at the X in that atmosphere? You grew up watching a lot of play. You know, you're a nice little player for your town, and from all of Minnesota. Mm-hmm. Everyone's watching on TV from out of the state too, so yeah. It's got to be a lot of pressure. How does that feel for you?
It was unbelievable. I was a sophomore, but I was playing with two seniors, so it helped me out to take care of their wings. All year long, but it was, it's an unbelievable feeling. It's surreal. You don't even realize it's actually happening, especially watching Hermantown, like your whole life growing up and watching the state tournament. It's unbelievable. And like I said, it's just surreal, and it's one of the best feelings you ever have.
Sure. So like this year, you're wearing the C for Hermantown. A lot of guys looking up to you that were in your spot before your sophomore year. What does that mean to you, and how are you gonna lead the way for Hermantown this year?
It's obviously a great honor. A lot of great players have come through here wearing the C for Hermantown. And just influencing the community and the younger players is huge, and they always look up to us. And I think coming back and choosing to play for Hermantown is big, and showing kids that your development is not anywhere else. Like, if you put in the work, and it doesn't matter where you are, you can play in Hermantown, Minnesota for a high school team, and you can play where you want. So I guess big to the younger kids in that program.
Absolutely. Blake, if you could play on a line with anyone in the history of hockey, who would it be?
Wayne Gretzky is an automatic.
Yeah.
It's crazy for him to ever play. And then I think Patrick Kane is like an American. He's a Mile grown up.
Set you up too.
Yeah, he set me up for sure. It's a lot of goals. So
yeah. Blake, what's your favorite hockey memory?
I think probably... I think probably playing, winning to go to the state tournament against Greenway my sophomore year, then playing the state tournament, and then probably, like I said, scoring against Russia, but that was probably feeling just playing Russia in general, for a kind of country, so.
Blake, your senior season's coming up. After that, the NHL draft, I mean, what would it mean to you to your new club?
Obviously, it'd be an unbelievable honor. I mean, it's everyone's dream to be drafted in the NHL and then eventually play, but obviously a lot of work ahead, and it's a big opportunity, though, and it's one of my goals, yeah.
If you could be any animal, what would you be?
Be a lion.
A lion? Why is that?
King of the jungle, man.
Fair enough. Any pregame rituals for you? Are you superstitious at all?
Yeah, superstitious. I guess I don't like looking at like Instagram or anything. I don't like anything just seeing like a goalie make a save. Don't like that at all. I won't like any pictures of that.
Do you go on social media all the day of the game?
Yeah, I'll go on. Hopefully, I can probably go watch highlights and stuff.
Of yourself?
No. Just Patrick Kane or something.
Absolutely. Favorite food?
My grandpa's rigatoni.
Black or white today?
White.
In your style before the game, what do you listen to?
Drake.
That's Drake.
A little bit.
Alright. Blake, thanks for coming on Locker Room Talk today. And best of luck this season with Hermantown. I can't wait to watch you in Duluth.
I appreciate that. Thank you. Yeah.